It is time for another thrift video. Okay, y'all, in this bag, this is a recyclable, reusable bag that I got at Dollar Tree, but in this bag is my 13th thrift haul of the year, so it's pretty full. See? Pretty full, y'all. So what we're gonna do, not a lot of talking, you know the drill, take the bag, move it out of the way, and just get on into all this thrifty dolly goodness. So here we go. I did these. I colored these by hand. They were the little things that you can get from Dollar Tree. I'll show you kind of up close. See? I did all the shading and everything. I love doing these, but sometimes I don't always have the time to do it. It's hard to pick. I think this one is my favorite because I really like how I did the dark to light on the candy canes and I put the green around it, but I really do like this one also. It is really cute because I used pink and teal and those are my favorite colors, but you know, that's just a little side note. First, I got this little frog. I just thought it was really, really cute and it was only 50 cents, so I wanted to share it with you guys. It's ceramic. It's just adorable. I also grabbed this hilarious Garfield bank. It says no bottom. It was only a dollar. There's no like stopper, but you know, I could make one of those or not use it as a bank, just use it as a figurine. I just thought it was hilarious and Garfield is so funny. He looks so grumpy. So I wanted to share that with you too. Next, I got this cute little cheerleader dress, little outfit for only 50 cents. I couldn't resist. I figured I have all different types of dollies, even though mostly what I show you guys are fashion dolls. I do have a lot of other dolls as well, and I thought that this was really cute, and maybe I could do something with it for my dollies, so I grabbed it. Next, I grabbed this bag for $3, and I'm gonna open it and show you what I got. This is what I got. You guys, this is so big. This dress. The dress is why I bought the doll. Really, couldn't see her, but didn't care. I thought, look at this dress, y'all. It is huge. Like, it's just ginormous. Now, I know this isn't her dress because she's a beach feet doll. See? And look, see where her feet end and then how much longer the dress is. This is a ball gown and a half. Look at this. Like, this is huge. And I saw all this pinkness and I thought, yep, definitely grabbing that for $3 because like the fabric alone is probably worth that. And look at this sparkly belt. That's like real rhinestones on there. It's really nice. Now I couldn't find a tag of any kind. I don't know if somebody homemade this or what, but it's exquisite. You know, I mean, it's not perfect, but it's really nice. And I thought that maybe I could zhuzh it up a little or something, but I just wanted it for this great big gown, to be honest. Now, she does have pink in her hair, which I do love. So I might swap her head to a, you know, different body and keep her because of the pink hair, but she has really bad, well, not the worst, but she has pretty bad glue root. But I have a remedy for that. It's super simple and I've started a video, so I'm definitely gonna have a tutorial for you guys of how I get rid of greasy glue hair in the near future, so look forward to that. And now she said $19.99 on her neck and $19.99 on her back. Now the dress, the closure is Velcro and it kind of doesn't want to come together there, but there, it's not that there's not enough fabric, it's just that the Velcro is too short. So I think what I'm going to do is ditch this Velcro, seeing how it's already coming off, and put some snaps on this beautiful gown because it definitely deserves snaps with all of this like bling and this big skirtness. I mean, look, I can do that and cover up everything. It's so huge, but there she is. So glad to have scored this. And I could see the pink from a mile away and I darted to it and I thought I have to grab whatever that is if it's doll related. So I did. Next, I got this bag of random for $3. So I'm gonna open it and show you what I got. Okay, so there was a bunch of random in that bag, but the things I'm gonna keep, this I was on the fence about, but I think I'm gonna keep it because it's Christmas time and I can use her as an ornament. She is a cute little handmade spoolie doll is what I call them. Because these are like spools that would have had thread on them. It probably wasn't. These were probably bought for crafting, but That's what I call them. I call them spoolie dolls. And she's really nicely made and she does have a cute face. So I am going to keep her. Next is this Minion. Not going to do a lot of talking about it, but I love Minions, so I'm keeping him. There were some tattoos. These are the ones I'm going to keep. Going to keep the Star Wars ones and these cute little ones and the pirate ones. Not sure what I'm going to do with them, but I just thought they were cute, so I'm going to keep them. Keeping these because I have that idea that I do want to make that one girl that I thrifted that has a missing piece of her leg into like a pirate, a pink pirate. So I'm keeping these funny little pirate coins for that idea. So someday, hopefully soon. And this Squeeze-a-mole was in there. I'm on the fence. It's kind of cute. I sprayed it already, but I'm definitely gonna run it through the wash if I keep it. So I just thought it was cute. I think it's a puffer fish, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep it yet or not. What would you do? Let me know in the comments. Now, the reason I bought the bag is this cutie. Oh my goodness. She is Alice from Alice in Wonderland. She is the Mattel version, 1987 on the back of her head and on her body. She is pretty much complete besides her shoes. She has her headband, her little apron here, and her little dress. This is really nice quality, and these are very white for it being as old as it is, and this too. So it probably didn't get played with that much. Her hair isn't even that mussed. It's really nice and shiny, so it will clean up very well, I am sure, and I am super glad to have her, cute little Alice, and add her to my collection. Next, I got this bag for $5, so I'm gonna open it and show you what I got. First is this Beach Feet girl. Not crazy about the Beach Feet, but I love her face. She says 2005 on her head and 1999 on her body. She has the regular articulation. Loving this swimsuit. It's super, super cute. And it's really made out of like thick, stiffy kind of, it's nice, but it's stiff material. And so that's cute. I like the little beads at the top. I really like her face. I couldn't really see. I kind of just took a chance on this bag. I just saw the three Barbies and I thought, well, if I don't like them, I guess I can re-donate them. But this one I like. I love the face. I love her smoky purpley eye makeup. Really pretty with her pearly lip. So she has pretty decent hair. It just needs, you know, a makeover like most of them do when you get them from the thrift store. And of course, I will probably rebody her if I keep her. I want to keep her head for sure. I think it's pretty. And I won't be able to do it right now because I don't have all my stuff out, you know, like I would normally. But I would like to rebody her just because I like her face. And I do like the swimsuit too. But I don't really leave a lot of my dolls in swimsuits if they're not like vintage or if I don't like love the swimsuit. So I'll probably make her a dress or something. Who knows? But I think she's super cute and I like her and I'm glad I got her for my collection. Next in the bag was this pretty lady. Look at her face. I don't have one with this face and this dark hair. Her head says 2010, her body says 2013. Now it's kind of a Model Muse body, but not exactly. See, it has like the cocked hip, but like the body is different than the Model Muse's, but the arms remind me of a Model Muse and stuff. So I don't know. I don't know if she's like a newer version of a Model Muse, but I really like her smoky eye makeup. Really pretty dark brown and then the lighter brown. Really, really pretty. And then I love the berry lip color. Super, super pretty. Now her hair is pretty nice. It just needs like a makeover. And I love the sparkly pink in this top. Super, super cute. Like this just, I don't think this is her outfit. It doesn't fit her very well, unless I'm mistaken. I mean, who knows? It could be her outfit, but it fits kind of odd, so I'm not sure. But she came with shoes. They hardly ever come with shoes, but she's got this weird stance. See how her legs are? It's kind of like turned in the one foot. So I'm sure it's supposed to be that way, but I've just never seen this body before, to be honest. So there's her. She's super pretty though. I love the face. And last in the bag was this girl. She says 2005 on her head, 2006 on her body. Now she does have the bend and snap knees, but she has that little funny, I've heard some people call the hobbit body. It's like shorter and littler. Now the dress, I like the dress. The dress is really nice and it's pink, pinky, pinky, pink. Loving the pink. The neck thing is broken, but I could fix that, no problem. And the Velcro on the back is fine. Nothing wrong with that. So I'm gonna keep definitely keep the dress. I'm not sure about her. I might re-donate her because I don't really care for the body, and her face is similar to that one over there, and I think I prefer that one. I'm not sure. I do like this makeup though. The makeup on her is really pretty, so I might rebody her. I might just re-donate her. Her hair is pretty nice. You know, nothing wrong with her. I just don't like keeping a lot of the same kind of doll if it doesn't speak to me in a way, you know. And like I said, she has the beach feet and this one has the hobbit body. So between the two, I'll just decide which one I like better, like which face and whatnot I like better. And then we'll see from there. And next, I grabbed this bag for $5. So I'm just gonna show you what I got. First, I got this cute purpley Barbie couch. It just says made in China on the inside, but I know it's Barbie because it has the Barbie symbol and it's pretty cute. It has kind of a, you know, like weird mark there where it's been bent or something, where the plastic is a different color. But you know, I could make a cushion or do something, but this I'm probably gonna keep because I think it's cute and it'd be nice to have for my dolls to sit on. Next in the bag was this bed, and it says B, so B for Barbie here, right there. Just made in China again on the bottom, no date, but it does this where you can make it like two beds if you flip it out, see, where two dolls could lay on it. Or if you do it like that, then it's for one doll, which I think is kind of cute and cool. I'm probably gonna keep this, but I'm on the fence kind of because I don't like keeping great big, you know, plastic pieces like this if I don't have a use for them, and I don't really have a use for it right now, but I might in the future, so I'm on the fence, but super cute. Next in the bag was this Cinderella, and it says 2011 on her head and 2012 on her back. It's a Mattel Cinderella. Now she does have her choker, but nothing else. She has kind of a cute face, but I'm not sure if I'm in love with it. So we're gonna see, kind of on the fence, not sure, but she isn't why I bought the bag. It's not really a big deal. I'm not mad at it. She has the clicky legs, and I might use her body as a swap body, who knows, but there she is, cute little Cinderella. Next in the bag was this Nikki doll. She's pretty cute. I like her face well enough. She does have the flat feet and the clicky legs though. She says 2001 on her head and 2015 on her body. She's pretty cute. I'm on the fence again with her. Like I said, this one and that one are not the reason I bought the bag. I bought the bag for the little couch because I knew I wanted to keep that, and there's some other dolls that I knew that I would want to keep. So she might get, you know, of course a makeover because I never re-donate them in this kind of condition, but I just might re-donate this one and that one. Who knows? But there's this cute Nikki. Next in the bag was this little Ariel. Now, anybody who knows me knows that I don't care for the molded on stuff, so I'm probably not going to keep this Ariel. I'll just fix her up and re-donate her. She is cute and all. She says 2005 on her head and 2011 on her back. You know, nothing wrong with it. It just doesn't really speak to my collector heart. So I'd rather give it to somebody who's gonna enjoy it, whereas I really wouldn't. So she does have the little pointed feet because she's supposed to be a ballerina. She's missing her tutu, and her legs are iridescent, which is kind of cool. But like I said, I'm just gonna give her back and let somebody else enjoy her. Next in the bag was this Millie face girl. Now she's grubby on her face anyway, and her hair definitely needs a glue treatment and is kind of sticky, but not too bad. Her head says 2013 and her body says 2010. Now this girl, I might use her body and swap it. I think this body might be too fair to do that girl because she's kind of tan, but I definitely have other girls with molded on, you know, body things that I don't care for, but I like the head, so I can do a swap and then just donate that one after I've swapped it to the thrift store, so yay. Next out of the bag is this girl. Now she has a grubby face again, like the last one. She says 2005 on her head, 2006 on her body. She does have the bend and snap knees. That one had clicky legs, if I didn't say. Now she's grubby, she's got something going on there on the back of her leg and everything, and her face. Her hair is okay though, it's not too bad. But if you see, I don't know how well you can see, she has like glittery eye makeup and it's pink. I do like that, and I like the color of her lips. It's a really pretty color. This dress is kind of cute too. I don't know if it's Barbie. It didn't have a Barbie tag that I could see, but I don't know. And I think this one has that Hobbit body again, so I'm not sure. on the fence about this girl. I kind of like how she's fair. She looks different than those two, even though she has a similar face, because she has the fairer skin and this like berry colored lip. So I might keep her just as she is. And like I said, do the swap on one of those other girls and only keep one of those. But her, I actually like the figures. She's the grubbiest one, but you know, I'm gonna clean them all anyway. So I'm definitely probably gonna keep her. Now, this girl is one of the reasons why I bought the bag. This Disney Descendants girl. Her head just says Disney and her body says 2014 Hasbro. Now, she's not perfect by any means, but she does appear to be complete as far as her outfit goes. She might be missing some accessories. I don't know. I do not have very many Descendant dolls. I think I only have maybe two other than her. Now, her hair is definitely going to need a treatment. You guys can see how it's just, whoa, just sticking out like that. But it doesn't feel too bad. It's probably gonna need a good, you know, it's not the best quality hair, but you know, she's Hasbro. I don't have that many Hasbro dolls. I don't know if they use the better quality hair when it's, you know, fantasy colored or not, but you know, I'm not mad at it. Look at these earrings. These are cute. These look like crowns. I just noticed those. It took me away from talking about the hair, but I do that sometimes. I have scatterbrain when I'm excited about a new doll. I think she's really, really pretty. Now, I'm not sure which one she is. Is she Mal? I'm not sure. I don't know. I don't know them well enough. It's sad. I should know them better, but I don't. But her outfit is, like I said, it appears to be complete. Look at these shoes. These are awesome. Like this doll and like one other doll were worth the $5 if you ask me. You know, she's gonna need, you know, a makeover because her nose looks a little dirty and her hands. Now this, I will probably have to repaint those because, you know, the black is coming off because she looks like she has gloved hands. But, you know, I'm not mad at that either. That's an easy fix, you know. And she has her hands, actually. They weren't off. So that's pretty cool. I got excited when I saw her because, like I said, I don't have very many Disney Descendant dolls. And I just thought it was super cool to add her to my collection. They are the extra articulation ones, you know, with the elbow and the wrist and the rotation there and the knee. It's not doing it too well, I think, because she has the tights on. So I think it would go farther if she didn't have the tights on. But these tights, I love these tights. These are super cute. But I'm super glad to add her to my collection. She is one of the reasons I bought the bag. So yay! So running out of room, y'all. That's why I knew that I couldn't put this doll in the pink dress, stand her up, because it would take up too much room, you know, over the background because the dress is so big. I didn't say that earlier, but that's why I put her down here. Next is this girl, and she was one of the absolute main reasons I bought this bag for $5. I had just said in a video not too long ago that I wanted a Tiana, but I didn't really care for the one that's currently out now, like the face and stuff and the outfit. And then it's like, I think sometimes that the doll universe hears me and says, okay, well, we're gonna fix that for you. And then I went into the thrift store and boom, there was this bag with this beautiful Tiana in it. Look at her cute little face with the side glance. Side glances are one of my favorite things. And she's not even really that must. Like this is about the only thing, this little tail here. You know, her bun is still in pretty good shape. Her little curls are still springy. Her face is beautiful. I love, love, love the lip on her. It has like the darker on the outside and then the lighter color on the inside, and it's super shiny and pretty. She's so pretty. And then she has, you know, this articulation with the elbow and the wrist, and then this knee articulation I love. I'm not so crazy about the like ankle articulation on these, but I'm not mad at it. The only thing is, yeah, with these, she's not as bad as some, is they don't really sit. They sit funny. So like I've talked about in another video, doing some kind of like shaving down in this area so that they will sit more properly. But this one, see how wide they sit when they sit? It's just kind of awkward and odd, you know, if you have like a princess doll and it sits like that. But anyway, I am going to love this Tiana because she is so, so pretty. I wanted one for a really long time, but I'm a picky collector, I will say, as far as faces and things go. If I'm not in love with the face, I'm probably not gonna get it because that's just how I am. But this one I love, and I am going to make her the best big old Tiana ball gown you have ever seen. I've had it in my head for the longest time, so this girl is the perfect opportunity, because she's naked, for me to craft a one-of-a-kind outfit for her. Big old lovely ball gown, which I love to do anyway. I just love her. She is so adorable. Love, love, love her. So glad I was able to score her. Absolutely awesome. Cannot wait to fix her up and add her to my collection. So happy about her. Yay. Well, y'all, that is all. I hope you enjoyed this number 13 for 2021 thrift haul that I had for you. It's kind of a big one, so I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for being with me, and thank you for watching. As always, I hope everyone watching is well and happy and safe, and that all the best things that are in this life that can come to you, I really, really hope that they will. I have to say, great, big, huge, huge subscriber love to all you lovely subscribers. Y'all are the best. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for coming along this journey and making our great big Dolly Barbie YouTube family grow by the day. It's so awesome. The numbers just keep going up. You guys are the best. I don't just say that. I really mean it. Love y'all. Thank you for coming along this journey and saying, hey, we like you and your Dolly silliness. So that's the best. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? I do everything in my power to give y'all the best Dolly day that I possibly can as a creator here. I just want you guys to be happy and well and safe, like I always say, and enjoy my silliness and my collector heart that loves dolls and loves sharing with y'all. So come on, join us, become part of the great big Dolly Barbie YouTube family we're building, and see what all crazy silliness we get up to. Well, y'all, that's all for this number 13 thrift haul, so you know what I'm gonna say.